Good morning, welcome to another episode of OMG It's Science, another day of badass science. I'm now walking to a new institute, IMO. I just went to bring back the keys of the car to my wife, drop at Biomed, and I'm now heading to a new institute. Let's go. Welcome to the University Science Campus. We are now currently up here, and I'm going to work in this building right here, IMO. So we're inside, guys. Welcome to the IMO building. I have to watch my feet so that I don't fall. Post for everyone except for me. I don't have a post box here. This here is one of the big IMO labs, so you can see it. We're now entering the lab where my office is. So here you can see the view I have out of my office, and this is my office. Welcome. Let's do some science. Okay guys, so now I'm going to start making my PPV based nanoparticle systems. I'm going to start with weighing off a two-phase system. Chloroform, not to be used on dates or at home. So I finished off weighing and adding the chloroform to the PPV to dissolve it, but as you can see, it's not really well dissolved, so I will leave this over the lunch break. So chloroform is a really volatile substance. If you would screw off the cap of the bottle and leave it open in the open air, it would be really fast gone. There would be no fluid anymore in the bottle. That's why I will use some parafilm and seal off the cap. And next to that, I will also put some aluminum foil around it. Seal it off really nicely so it's protected from the light. Okay, so now I'm going to check if the PPV is dissolved in the chloroform. This track is on the radio in the lab, you gotta put it power. Okay, it looks like it's nicely dissolved now, so let's add the water phase to it. And this is after adding the water phase to the chloroform. So this is how a two-phase system looks like. Fancy science. So this kind of effect, it happens because the chloroform and the water, they do not like to mingle with each other, so they stay nicely separated. So you can see on top the water phase, and on the bottom our polymer dissolved in chloroform. So let's now mix it up. Now the core competence of IMO, the Institute for Material Research, is actually the development and characterization of a wide variety of materials that can be used in all kinds of applications like bioelectronics, nanotechnology,
as broad as you can think of. And IMO has a really strong collaboration with IMEC, the Inter-University Microelectronics Center in Leuven. And we also have a wide variety of research domains like printable electronics, like these flexible solar cells. We have nanotechnology for bioimaging, as I'm designing, or they can also be used for drug development and so on and so on. But I think that our nanoparticle sample is ready. Let's go. Now that our samples have done stirring around, we're going to make nanodroplets. And we're going to do that with the ultrasonication tip. Ultrasonication tip is going and making a lot of noise. So what we're actually doing now is we're using ultrasonic waves, so sound wave, to generate such a force that the two phases start becoming miscible and create nanodroplets. So droplets in the nanometer size range. So you can hear it makes a hell of a lot of noise. And then the surfactant, the soap, which we have in it, stabilizes these nanodroplets, and then we can continue on with our synthesis. So we're done with ultrasonication, and as you can see now, it's a nicely one-phase solution of chloroform nanodroplets in water. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to put this on a hot plate and let the chloroform evaporate, and then you get nicely nanoparticles of your conjugated polymer in a water-based dispersion. That it's on the hot plate, I'm going to build a nice aluminum foil shield around it so that it's protected from light. And now we have to wait for 24 hours. Okay, so that was the end of another awesome day filled with badass science. I gave you a look into the world of nanoparticle synthesis and showed you one way of making wonderful nanoparticles. So, see you next time on OMGitsScience. Science out.